Hey everyone, this is Elsa's Magical Ice Palace. It is essentially a sequel to 2015's top-selling Lego set, Elsa's Sparkling Ice Castle. This one costs about twice as much as the previous one, but it's not twice as large. However, it does have more than twice as many pieces, giving it a lot more detail and making it a lot more believable and more magical than the original. Case in point, this main entranceway, which uses just two stickers and everything else, is built up with proper Lego pieces. Enough different pieces that there are many different facets that you see at the points where the different parts come together. And those all reflect light differently, makes it look very crystalline. Also, they have a very nice entrance feature. You pull back on this small handle right here and both the doors open at the same time. Someone can actually come out to the door to greet you, and then you can go just inside that door, place a figure like that, and when you close this up, everybody goes in together. Very smooth. The balcony up above that also uses just two stickers, but everything else is built up nicely. And you can just see all of the edges of all of these transparent light blue pieces and how, depending upon how the light hits it, it looks a little bit different. It really looks like it's made from crystal or ice. Around the side, here's another moving feature. The staircase actually comes out just by spinning this little piece right here. It looks like a round ice knob. You just turn that. This will retract or extend out. The other side features a very small slide, which is actually a brand new piece from Lego for this season. It's much shorter than the previous ones, and there's a staircase on the other side to allow you to come up to the top of that and then just let somebody go and they'll slide around to the front. Here's how that looks from the inside, just a few stairs going up to it, and that's very near the dining table and the kitchen area, which has some things out on it, including a chocolate bar and a bit of a cake there. They also have a single carrot in the sink and some more stuff under a dome there. I'm not sure exactly what the green things are supposed to represent. There's also a cabinet down below. You can put something very small in that cabinet, but only very, very small. But it's nice that it opens. These seat cushions, the toppers on them, are actually printed pieces from Lego, not stickers that you have to put on there. That was nice to see. In the back, that is something that requires a sticker. You see a little bit of kind of shimmering or shine on the music sheet there. It actually uses kind of a glitter style. All the stickers that are included in the set have kind of a glitter backing to them, which makes them iridescent, and they change color a little bit depending upon how you look at them. Here's a view of the entire ground floor of the castle so you get an idea of how big it is. Upstairs is a bedroom with not too many things in it. There's a rug on one side and a bed on the other. Each of those uses stickers for decorations. There's also a mirror which has that glitter kind of effect to it, even though it actually is reflective. So you can see yourself in it if you look, but you're kind of pixelated. Up above all that is a chandelier element, which is almost entirely comprised of transparent pieces, just one white piece in the center to help tie it all together. If you want to change the shape of your play space, you can easily remove the entire upper floor of the castle and just bring it down side by side like this. You can put it on the other side. You can consider this to be a separate small house, or you can kind of bring them end to end like this to represent a little bit more of an enclosed space, or bring it like this to change the shape of things even further. If you want, you can even put the upper floor on backwards, but then you don't have access from the side here, so you'd need to kind of rearrange things a bit. The set includes a comically miniaturized version of Marshmallow, the enchanted snowman, or I like to call him a snow golem, with a printed piece for the very hollow-looking eyes and some articulation. You can actually make this guy look like he's dancing a little bit. Let me see if I can get that to balance because he is kind of heavy. There we go. Got him to balance there. He's got ball joints for just the upper parts of the legs, kind of at the hips. So you can rotate those around in different ways. Same thing for the shoulders. There are some limitations to how far you can go, but you can overcome some of those limitations by just twisting it around. you know, to get different amounts of movement in different directions. And you can also move the fingers individually. So you can give like a thumbs up like that, or it can look like he's waving completely like that. See, a very happy marshmallow. From the back, there's not much to be seen because most of this is built this way. So this is kind of the top of all the bricks here. And then at the end, you just turn it right side up. It looks pretty good, even though the proportions are awkward. Here's a closer look at Elsa, Anna, and Olaf. I really like the metallic blue that they used on Elsa's dress, both on the top and also for the bit down here at the base. And you can see how that shines as it turns in different directions. They also got plenty of gold into Anna's outfit, which looks like it comes from Frozen Fever. Olaf uses the two little raisin dots on a printed round tile here, and still uses the same head as the previous version of him. There's that glittery sheen again. They've used it on the cape. You can turn this cape around if you want to see that iridescent shininess from the front most of the time, but I think it looks better like this when you actually let the tail kind of drag behind, because it is taller than the entire figure. There's nothing else to be seen on the backs of these. Everything just fits up nice and snug, and you get two different points where you can place miniature accessories on each of these mini dolls, one on the back for each and one on the top for each. But there are no accessories included with this set, like bows and things that you could put in there, but you can use ones from other Disney princess sets from Lego, and also things from Friends and Elves. You can also put two people on this kind of toboggan train that's included with the set. And here it looks like Elsa is extending how far this will go or how fast it'll go by creating ice in front of them. That's a little two-piece accessory that's also included with the set. And this one in the back is kind of used as a cargo trailer right now. It has some ice blocks on it and also a crystal that could represent ice, or it could be something a little bit more special than that as a gem. And each of these cars, if you will, is separatable, so you can use just one at a time if you want, or two at a time if you want. And each one also has this jumper piece used at the back. Come on, Anna, she doesn't want to get off. She does not want to get off. She's having too much fun. There we go. The jumper piece allows you to place Olaf there on either one, so you can do that on the front or on the back if you want to. Lastly, they have a little bit of an outdoor scene here. This can kind of represent a small castle or a bit of a fence line. And it comes with, the whole set comes with a total of four of these Snogies. You saw two of them in the castle already up to this point, but you can kind of pose one right there just at the entrance. And this is a seesaw or teeter-totter that actually works. Just sends them back and forth like this. A little bit of a tree here, and there's some icicles that are just hanging down from it. Nothing else to be seen from the other side of this, but it's a nice little extra thing just to kind of expand the scene a little bit. My favorite feature of this entire set by far is this entranceway and how that works. It's smooth, it works very well as a Lego mechanism, but also the fact that you're just pulling straight out, pushing straight in, and yet the doors are opening off to the sides, and they don't feel directly connected to the point that I'm holding on to. It really does feel a little bit like there's some kind of magic or some kind of hidden mechanism that's powered behind this. I don't know how to quite convey that through a video. Hopefully just from how exactly it's moving and how smooth it is, you'll get some idea of that. But you really need to put your hands on there to feel, you know, at first it's moving, the doors are moving more slowly, and then they actually speed up as it gets in closer to there because of the geometry of the connectors. So that's really nice. But when you consider that you can put somebody on the back and have them kind of meet you at the door, and then you can have somebody else actually go inside, you don't have to take them all the way in. You just use this same mechanism to not only take them inside, but close the doors at the same time. In this age, when we have so many action features from Lego that are about shooting things or transforming one vehicle into another type of vehicle, from a car into an airplane, into a rocket ship, this is one of the nicest action features that I've seen on a Lego set in a long time. It's just pretty perfect. Beyond that, the entire visual impact of this castle is very strong and very pleasing, and I am very glad that they relied very little on stickers, just these four. They're not key. I think these ones for the door are important, but you could do without them. But most of what I like that I see here comes from the Lego pieces themselves. It's very pure and genuine in that way. All these extra lines that you're seeing are from the walls of the transparent Lego pieces, and they refract light in different ways, and some of them absorb just a little bit, so you get some darker areas, some brighter areas, and it just looks really nice and so much better than the previous one. The only thing that is a little disappointing to me is, again, the lack of stuff on this upper floor. There just aren't that many things you can actually do here with what they've included in the set. At least down below, you know, you can greet guests, you can come over here and do some singing practice, eat, drink, be merry, do some food preparation. There's the slide you can play on. You can chase snow geese up and down the stairway, maybe try to trap them with the way that this all retracts away. But when you get up to the top, you can, you know, look in the mirror, you can talk between a couple of people, you can rest, and you can look off the balcony. Just a little bit limited relative to the rest of the set. All told though, I am so glad they made this new version of the castle at all, first of all, and also that they made it so much more substantial than the 2015 version. Yes, it does cost a lot more, but I really feel like it is worth saving up for because you get so much more and it just looks so much better. It really makes you feel good when you look at it, even if you're not interacting with it, just having it on display. But that's enough from me. Now it is your turn to share what you think about the set and what are your favorite and least favorite features of it. Leave your thoughts in a comment down below, and it'll be much appreciated by myself and other viewers who want to get different opinions. Thank you so much for watching, and if you want to see more of my videos, be sure to check back on my channel on a regular basis to make sure you don't miss anything. The next video is already on its way, so I'll be talking to you again very soon.